Hello, it's 9 p.m. in Djibouti. It's time to English New Edition for tonight's headlines. Here we have the head of state, Ismail Omar Guelleh, inaugurated the first manufacturing of palm oils at Pika 12. Concerning Somalia, American Army aircraft kills times 9 of combatant Shabab. In France, a violent incident in Paris for the test days of mobilizations of yellow gilet. Welcome to our newsroom. The President of the Republic sponsors the ceremony of the official inauguration of a palm oil production plant at Pika 13. The President of the Republic, Ismail Omar Guelleh, has sponsored this Sunday the ceremony of the official inauguration of a palm oil production plant at Pika 13. Upon his arrival at the scene, the head of state was received by the Minister of Economy and Finance, Idias Moussa Dawale, chairman of the board of Golden Africa Djibouti, who is also the honorary consul from the Republic of Djibouti to Malaysia, Mr. Fouad Hayal Said, and his closest associate. At the beginning of the occasion, the President of the Republic unveiled the commemorative plaque of the factory, the first of its kind in the Horn of Africa. Golden Africa Djibouti has invested about US $13 million in this project, generating around 2,200 direct jobs and hundreds of indirect jobs. The President of the Republic visited the various facilities of this plant, which will produce about 16,000 meters per year of edible oil. The selections of Golden Africa Group, Djibouti, our country, was pad randomly, but because of the wise policy of the President of the Republic to attract foreign investment. The President of the Parliament, Mohamed Ali Humed, several members of the government, the National Assembly, member of diplomatic corps, accredited to our country, representative of the non-governmental organizations and other guests attend this ceremony. It should be noted that this industrial project will help meet the need of vegetable oil on the local and regional market, according to the chairman of the board of the Golden Africa Djibouti.
Shoy gani hiriya, the workshop of Bahipet, Salida Golden Africa, Djibouti. The workshop of Bahipet,
Salida Golden Africa, Djibouti.
The workshop of Bahipet,
Salida Golden Africa, Djibouti.
The workshop of Bahipet,
Salida Golden Africa, Djibouti.
The chairman of the board of director of Golden Africa Djibouti thanked in his speech the head of state for sponsorship the inauguration ceremony of the palm oil production plant, which will accompany the effort of the government to improve food security in Djibouti. He said the opening of this great industrial project is only an idea that has been concretized in recent years to make it a reality today. We hope that it will take advantage of the many benefits and achievements that have been created to positively contribute to the growth of economic progress and trade between the Republic of Djibouti and neighboring countries. For his part, the Minister of Economy and Finance, Ilyas Moussa Dawale, stressed the importance of this great industrial project aimed at promoting economic and social development while the country is significant progress in overcoming the obstacles of to the development of the industrial sector in our country. The President of the Republic, Ismaïla Omar Guelleh, recall that the inaugurations of this new factory revitalized the national economy and testified to the growing confidence of investors in our country.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wassalatu wassalamu ala nabiyyihi al-huda wal-rahma wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.
I would like to say in a few words all the pleasure I have today to participate in the inaugurations of this palm oil plant of Golden Group Africa. The inaugurations of a new factory is always a highlight that represents above all the economic dynamism of our country and the confidence shown by investors to us. Indeed, the total investment of this project is about $13 million with substantial infrastructure, including a pipeline of more than 3 kilometers to ship the oil from the ship to the plant. The facility includes a cooking oil refinery, blow molding machines to produce jerry cans, oil filling machine, and other service facilities such as boilers, water treatment facilities on more than 120 hectares. All this translates is my opinion that investing, developing and innovating on Djiboutian territory is not only possible but also competitive. This large-scale project therefore aims to serve our economy and more broadly our region. Ladies and gentlemen, it is understood that development really only starts with industrialization, so I am delighted that we can bring these new stones to the building of our economic emergence. The inauguration of this plant is also a source of optimism and confidence in the future, in that it allows to the creation of several hundred mostly Djiboutian jobs in addition to those already accumulated during the construction of the plant, commissioning of the plant. Finally, the project that brings us together today confirms, if need be, the technological advance in industrial process as well as the training of Djiboutian workers in them will better equip our human resources for the economy of emergence. Before concluding my remarks, I would like to pay tribute to Golden Group Africa for choosing Djibouti to set up this factory and to have belief in our country and its many assets. I share their belief that Djibouti and its economy remain a choice for the future. In addition, the President of the Republic delivered a speech in Somali in which he welcomed the step taken by the chairmen of the Board of Directors of Golden Africa Djibouti to set up this palm oil production plant, calling the employees to make effort to improve the performance of this industrial building.
First
of all, we would like to thank Mr. Fouad Hail Saïd, the chairman of the board of Golden Africa Djibouti, who is also the honorary consul of our country in Malaysia. He belongs to a well-known family in Yemen who strives to fight against poverty in this brother country. Despite the war in Yemen, Mr. Fouad's commercial facilities and factories, which employs about 22,000 workers, continue to operate. Today, Golden Africa has decided to open its palm oil production plant in Djibouti, and we should welcome this initiative and pay tribute to Mr. Fouad Hail Saïd. It will undoubtedly generate hundreds of jobs for the citizens and will become welcome a large number of workers and employees in the year to come, especially after its expansion and the opening of other factories. The president of the company has expressed his desire to rehabilitate and train Djiboutian workers, and we hope that another number of citizens will get jobs in this industrial project. Finally, government should play a major role in the fight against poverty and unemployment. The training of human resources to be able to integrate in factories, farms, fishing and other promising areas. We reiterate our congratulations to the companies and wish him every success. The President of the Republic, Ismail Omar Guelleh, has received today at the Presidential Palace Mr. Tibor Peter Nagy Jr., Assistant Secretary of State for African Affairs. There are overseas missions in the sub-region. The talks between the head of state and the top U.S. official focused on bilateral relations between the two countries and ways to promote and strengthen them. Issues relating to the safeguarding of peace and security in the sub-region were also mentioned. Djiboutian Foreign Minister Mahmoud Ali Youssef attended the meeting. In an interview with the National Press, Deputy Assistant Secretary of State for African Affairs, Mr. Tibor Peter Nagy Jr., so welcomed the audience of the head of state as well as the contents of the discussion. Listen to him.
For me, the main topic was expressing the appreciation of the United States of America for the very warm and cordial relationship and cooperation we have with Djibouti. What an important country Djibouti is for our relations, and we just appreciate everything that that Djibouti has done, and we also look forward to a future. Hopefully we can grow our economic relations as well, because we would like to have many more American businesses come to Djibouti and invest in Djibouti, and especially invest in your young people, because you have such a young population. It's at the top of our list. It occupies a critical place in Africa in so many different ways. So we consider Djibouti one of our most important partners. So it's a very top priority.
For his part, the Minister of Foreign Affairs International Cooperation, Mahmoud Ali Youssef, pointed out that the Assistant Undersecretary of State for African Affairs has a great deal of experience on all the issues of the continent, as well as he has long been Ambassador of the United States to Addis Ababa. The President of the National Assembly, Mohamed Ali Hamed, held an important meeting with the women's parliamentarian Djibouti, who are in number in the hemicycle. This meeting made it possible to take stock of the activities of women parliamentarian in parliament and those of the training of gender equity that took place recently at the National Assembly. The development of women parliamentarian in the various parliamentary debates was widely discussed during the meeting between the President of the National Assembly, Muhammad Ali Ahmed, and women parliamentarian, in accordance with the will of the President of the Republic to involve women in all spheres of economic and social political life. This meeting allowed to discuss ways and means to better coordinate the activities of women parliamentarian in plenary sessions or during commissions. The President urged women parliamentarian to be more involved in intervening alongside their colleagues in debate, stating that the point of women parliamentarian will be plus to improve economic and social political governance, he said. The Minister of Economy and Finance in charge of industry, Elias Musa Dawale, has received in audience on Sunday a strong delegation from the Japan Association for the Economy and Development of Africa, led by its President Tetsuro Yano. The Japanese delegation was introduced to the ministers by the accredited Japanese ambassador to Djibouti, Tatsuo Arai, who attended the meeting after the words of welcome from the Minister of Economy and Finance, responsible for industry, the President of the Japan Association for the Economy and Development of Africa. Tetsuro Yano introduced the member of this important delegation, including politicians and business leader. He pleaded to strengthen economic cooperation between the two countries, not to mention his thanks to the government of Djibouti for the facilities granted to Japanese self-defense forces stationed in Djibouti. During the meeting with the member of this Japanese association, the Minister of Economy and Finance in charge of industry said that the friendship between the two countries is fruitful, mentioned all the projects financed by the Japanese authority in the country to accompany the transformations of Djibouti, as well as the strengthening of regional integration, like the project of rehabilitation of the National Road 1 connecting Ethiopia to the ports of Djibouti. Like the international community, Djibouti is launching the National AIDS Week under the patronage of the Ministers of Health, Jamal El-Melkiye, at the People's Palace. This year's theme of the World AIDS Day is Know Your Status. The choice of this theme aims to encourage everyone to know their HIV status. Present at the celebrations were UNICEF representative and acting United Nations agency representative Ms. Janabu Maonde and RNDP chairman Sininu Farah, who representative of the C president and the department executive from the Ministry of Health. The screenings consist of health workers in all health centers with the necessary kit to systematically offer all patients in consultations an HIV test and inform them of the result. The goal is to reach the first 19 of the strategic objective to screen 19% of people living with the HIV in our country by 2020, increase the percentage of the HIV who know their status in our country. The RNDP network's chairwoman Sninu Farah has said, "Today our main challenge is to overcome the stigmas and discriminations of AIDS patients. For this, we especially need the support of the country's institution." The 39th meeting of the Committee of Governors and Central Banks, a member of the COMESA, opened this morning at the Kempinski Hotel. This meeting brought together experts from a number of countries that had a goal to discuss the agenda items, the implementation of the regional payment system, the financial statement of the clearing house and other salient point. The work of the Committee of Financial and Monetary Affairs consists mainly of assessing the progress made in the implementations of the regional payment and the settlement system and the decisions of the 22 meetings of the Committee of the Governors Central Bank on the implementation process of the Comesa Financial Stability Assessment Framework. The financial and monetary expert mentioned the progress report on the implementations of the RIPC, but also the effort of the sensitization of the stakeholders on its issue as its use for the benefit of the region, particularly through the associations and the syndicates of the respective commercial banks. The objective of the system is to stimulate economic growth through the expansions of the intra-regional trade. This event brought together experts from the central banks of COMESA members country. As part of the last meetings of the year 2018, members of the Office of the National Associations of Local Authority of Djibouti met at the headquarters of the association in December 2018. These were composed of the President, Ms. Fatouma Wale Osman, Mayor of the City of Djibouti, the First Vice President, Mr. Mohamed Ahmed Ismail, President of the Regional Council of Obok, Second Vice President, Abdurrahman Younis Ari, President of the Regional Council of Dekhel, Secretary General, Mr. Omar Hussein Omar, President of Tadjoura Regional Council, Deputy Secretary General, Mr. Omar Ahmed Waiz, President of the Ali Sabih Regional Council, Deputy Treasurer, Mr. Mohamed Omar Ismail, President of the Boulaos Municipality. Finally, the auditors, Mr. Elmi Buha Gudalde, President of the Regional Councils of Arta. The second edition of the International Fair will open tomorrow these doors to the People's Palace. At the stand of the exhibitors are ready to receive the public. Is the announcement was made this afternoon by the President of the Chamber of Commerce, Mr. Yusuf Musa Dawale. Here is his statement. Present. The President of the Chamber of Commerce, Yusuf Musa Dawale, said that more than 32 countries will participate tomorrow in this major event in the Horn of Africa, and more than 320 companies, institutions and production factories will be among us. It is an opportunity for all Djiboutians to take full advantage of this event. The launch of the second international fair in Djibouti, which will take place from 3 to 10 December, many private and foreign operators have already taken place on the Esplanade of the People's Palace. Listen to this report. For this unprecedented event, the Chamber of Commerce of Djibouti intends to mark our country a showcase for promoting the integrations of national and regional trade. This event is intended to bring together supplier customers and service providers from Djibouti and its sub-region and all their partners around the world. The opportunity was too good to highlight the beautiful feat. And the feat that was the huge success of the first edition is of the fair entitled Djibouti Gateway to Africa, a big event that offers an excellent opportunity for the companies present to develop their business networks and expand their customer portfolio. It must be said that the organization said that the first fair of last year was the occasion of the celebration of 130 years of existence of the Chamber of Commerce of Djibouti, and which has turned into a real success and a formidable promotional showcase for the role of commercial and logistic hub that want to play our country. A success with many players, starting with the President of the Republic, Ismaël Omar Guelleh, who visited the first international fair in Djibouti, or he visited the various stand which was placed for this purpose. Through this activity, the institution wishes to say that to attract Djibouti attention of economic and commercial partners around the world. and thus shine the spotlight on the important development of port and logistic infrastructure, positioning the country as platform of redistribution of goods in the region. At last, the second fair will welcome hundreds of company, economic operator and local investor, but also those from the region and around the world. For the international scene, the US military has reportedly carried out air strikes in Somalia, which claimed the lives of 9 Shabab terrorists. The United States comment for Africa, AFRICOM, stated that no civilian was killed in the last UAV strikes in coordination with the Somali government near Lebede in the countries of the Horn of Africa. U.S. forces will use all effective and appropriate methods to protect the Somali people, including counter-terrorism military operations conducted in partnership with the Somali government. The African Union missions in Somalia and Somalia's National Armed Forces, the Al-Qaeda-linked terrorist group, continues to control the southern of the central region of the countries after being close as chased out of Mogadishu a few years ago. This is it for the news. Thanks for watching us.